Everybody, welcome to the course Applied Statistics. I'm Mariam Hassan Liu, and in this video, I'm going to introduce the course briefly and also introduce my plan for upcoming 8 weeks. You may know this course is designed for DBA students, and it's one of the most critical courses for DBA program because many DBA students for completing their dissertations, quantitative analysis may need some statistics tools and techniques. And that's why we try to design and deliver this course in a way to cover and address most of these requirements for this program. And I try to deliver this course in a way to address your requirements for implementing statistical techniques and tools in doing your dissertation. At first, I need to mention you this course is combo course. It means we have hybrid and online students. Hybrid students should attend the class, and for online students, all meetings will be recorded on Zoom and will be posted for you on your course page, and you can attend the class in online Zoom meeting, and also you can check out the video and review them later. And at the first, I prefer to take a look at Moodle course page. Moodle course page first part is about introduction. Introduction, you can see my profile to get familiar with my background. And also you can see my welcome letter. In welcome letter, I try to mention you some critical and important requirements you need to consider before getting started the course. And then you can see my contact information to communicate with me during this course, and also about your textbook and some supplementary files and documents like syllabus that I will talk in detail about the syllabus in the first session, and also educational philosophy. Educational philosophy means the policies, discipline, and expectation during this course from students. And late policy work, and also some supplementary required documents you need to check out all these files for passing this course successfully. And in introduction, finally, you can see my brief schedule for this course for 8 weeks. I will go over all these schedule in detail. And like the other courses you may have in this university, for each week, you can see a separate section including required materials and links for your assignments. And also you can see the link for Zoom session for online students. And whatever you need, such as a video, such as a PowerPoint slide, such as a data set that I will post for you every week, you can see for each week in a separate parts for a week. And if I want to start talking about my plan for this course, before talking about the plan, I will mention you, this course is designed for DBA program. It means it's not basic statistics. It's not introduction to statistics. It means that I expect you to know terminology, definitions, and basic concepts statistics, because we have just 8 weeks and we want to cover some techniques and tools for quantitative analysis. So I prefer to reduce the time for lecturing. I prefer to reduce the time for manual calculation to talk about the definitions, formulas. We will work in class so practically. It means that every week I will post data set for you and you will work on data set in class. And we prefer to assign the most part of the session to practical working on real world data instead of lecturing about the introduction of the statistic tools and techniques. It means that I expect you to pass the basic concept of statistics and being in class as a DBA, as a doctoral level student. Okay? And my plan for this course, like the common way of teaching this course, because I teach this course, I think more than 5 years I teach this course, and my plan is starting with introduction of the statistics, find the role of the statistics in real world, find the place of the statistics in business and real world. And then after talking about the introduction, we will talk about the data structure, type of data, and how to gather data, the methods for data gathering, sampling, because it's so important. Distinguishing the type of data is one of the most important parts of a statistic, because each type of data requires particular tools and techniques based on its type. The first, I want the students to practice a lot and distinguishing the type of data. After gathering data, distinguishing the type of data, we need to do descriptive analysis. Descriptive analysis means organizing, summarizing, and visualizing the data. We have two different separate parts for describing. At the first, we visualize the data, and then we do some numerical measurements for describing the data. We don't beyond the summarizing and organizing, just describing at the first step. And then, before finishing descriptive analysis, we need to start inferential analysis. Inferential analysis means we are going to make a decision. We are going to do some estimation, some explanation on our data, creating some decisions. And for implementing inferential analysis, we need to know, we need to get familiar with probability theory. Some discrete and continuous probability distribution will be introduced for you, and then we get started hypothesis testing. Hypothesis testing, we need to know how to formulate our statements in mathematical hypothesis, how to test our statements about real world populations, and then how to interpret and analyze the output. After working on hypothesis testing, we get familiar with ANOVA, analysis of variance, and then we introduce correlation and regression analysis. Finally, for correlation and regression analysis is one of the most important applicable parts for DBA students, because many of the students for completing their dissertation, quantitative analysis, require correlation and regression analysis for estimation of some critical parameters, such as, for example, I have one student now, one DBA student, because I'm a methodologist for DBA students dissertation committee, and I monitor and actually advise students in selecting and working with appropriate tools and techniques, and I actually monitor and I assess their methodologies. My students is working on estimation of the GDP for a country. Okay, for estimating the GDP, we need to use correlation and regression analysis, because we estimate GDP as a dependent variable based on some independent variables in economy. And so we start the story from data, from zero to hero. It means we start from gathering data, to finally, we try to generate some helpful result as estimation for real world business and economy. During these 8 weeks, I prefer to reduce, as I mentioned to you before, I prefer to reduce the time of lecturing and focus more on working on data in class. So you need to bring your own laptop in class. I post data set for you on your course page, and in class, we work on real-world data sets, practically. This course is completely practical. We prefer to study theory at home, we review the theories at home, and then we apply these theories on software. The software we work in class is Excel and also SPSS. So everything is so practical, and I try to enable you to do your dissertation successfully. This course is supported using appropriate assignments. The assignments for this course including 3 parts, 8 learning engagements. You know, learning engagements including actually learning has 25 points. And if you want to get complete 25 points, you need to respond some question weekly, and also you need to respond the other students' post. At least 2 responses should be provided by you for getting the complete 25 points for each learning engagement. You need to follow some standards like APA standards in writing your post, and I will let you know about the details of consideration later in the first session. 2 case studies is also designed for supporting this course. They are so important because for case studies, all the practices we do in the class should be delivered in a report. The data set is posted for you for case study. The data set came from real world, and you are going to prepare some analysis, and also using your own words, you're going to create report, interpret on output, on result. That's the important part for your result, for your reports, your own analysis, your own interpret on generated reports, on generated numbers. And then finally, I expect you to write a final research paper. This course, final research paper, is a little bit different from the other courses, because in this course we expect you to do quantitative analysis. We don't have just descriptive research, just describing the concepts. I expect you to gather data for an applied topic, from healthcare, from banking, finance, investment, real estate, any different particular, because data is everywhere for all different topics. You can gather data and you can develop all tools and techniques we practice during 8 weeks on your data set. For example, at the first, you need to describe your data, you need to introduce your data, you need to describe your data using some graphs and visual techniques, and then some numerical measurement for summarizing your data. And then based on your topic, based on your purpose, you can develop some detailed and deep quantitative analysis like regression, correlation, or hypothesis testing based on the topic and based on the purpose of your requirements. And you need to prepare a PowerPoint presentation. Last week, I expect you to present your PowerPoint file in a class for your students and for me. This is a great opportunity for you to practice how to talk about our research, how to talk about our purpose, how to talk about. This is a great opportunity for represent yourself. And I really enjoy this course, teaching this course and working with you guys. And I look forward to see you soon. I wish you best of luck. See you soon. Thanks for watching this video. Bye.